Hey, it's Mark. I'm a chef living in Paris. Today we are going to be braising some short ribs. Now this is my favorite way to cook. You may not know what a braise is, but learning this technique is going to up your cooking game. It's also going to save you a lot of money, and that is because braising uses cuts of meat that we consider chewy or tough, and it takes that connective tissue and the sinew and breaks it down and just seeps into our sauce. This does take a lot of time, but don't let that scare you away from making a recipe like this. It takes a little bit of prep in the beginning, so we're gonna go ahead and get started on that now. Because we're cooking these for so long, we're cutting everything into large chunks. I'm gonna cut these potatoes into about 4 pieces. Actually, I changed my mind, just 2 pieces. So these are my short ribs here. It came in 2 pieces and I had the butcher cut it into more manageable chunks. I salted these yesterday. Salting is so important. You cannot underestimate the importance of marinating in advance. What salting does is it takes the moisture and draws it out of the meat. That then dissolves the salts and all of that flavor gets absorbed back into the meat. And that also goes a long way in tenderizing this. This meat has a lot of tough components and sinew. So we want that to break down, and that's just gonna add a ton of flavor into our sauce and the dish. Whenever you braise, the first step is to brown the meat. So I'm gonna take these pieces and put them in bone side up. I'm just gonna fill these up, but I wanna make sure that everything is touching the bottom of the pan. So it's okay if you have to do this in a couple of batches. And you wanna be patient with these because you want them to really get nice and caramelized, and that can take a couple minutes on each side. This is the color we're looking for. Whenever you have that brown, it means that you're releasing all of the sugars, so that really maximizes the flavor on that meat. Just the best sound. You'll notice that there's a lot of stuff sticking to the bottom. Don't worry, we're not gonna let that burn to the pan. That has a ton of flavor, so we do not wanna waste that. I'm gonna add the potatoes now. And I'm gonna use this spoon to scrape up a little bit of those juices. I'm even gonna add some stock to help. Salt at every stage of the process. Now that these potatoes have some color on them, I'm gonna go ahead and take them out. Bacon. Now I'm gonna add our aromatic vegetables. I'm adding more stock to help me scrape everything off the bottom. I'm gonna add more salt now. I'm gonna add a little bit of butter now. Garlic. Adding a little bit of tomato concentrate balances this dish with some acidity. I'm gonna put all of this meat back in the pan now. It might seem like a bit of a tight squeeze, but this is gonna shrink down a lot, so don't stress it. Now I'm gonna put these potatoes back in as well. Wine is also a source of acidity. It looks like I'm adding a lot here, but it's really gonna reduce out all of the alcohol, and then we're gonna be left with some sweetness in there as well. I'm adding a little bit of stock too. It's okay if it's not completely submerged, but you want it pretty full of liquid there. The bouquet garni and other savory herbs are a great thing to use for really long recipes like this. Everything is just going to infuse together, and over hours we're going to be left with this amazing combination of flavors. You'll get a little bit of scum that floats to the top of the surface. I like to take that out. You don't have to, but yuck. This has come to a boil now, so I'm going to put the lid on, turn the heat down. Usually at this point, you would put this in the oven, but I don't have one, so I'm gonna let this do its thing for 2 to 3 hours and go do something else. This has been cooking for about 2.5 hours now, so I'm just gonna check to make sure it's done. Looks like it. Yeah, you can tell when the meat is done because it's going to be fork tender. It's literally falling off the bone here. Okay, so we're all ready to plate this up. This is a pretty heavy dish, so I've got a really simple salad here to accompany the beef. So I'm going to start off with a little bit of that. Add a few potatoes, and then some of this beautiful beef we got. I'm gonna drizzle some sauce on top of that and finish off with a few herbs. Just add a little bit of pepper, and there we go. That's it for today. I think you're gonna find that patience really pays off. This is one of my favorites. If you liked what you saw, you can like and subscribe for more, and keep an eye out for me next time.